mother-in-law's tongue-tie. Fancy that. Honeysuckles sucked and honey-bathed close to Henry's ancient limestone walls, and Florrie, awake, bayoneted her turkey head from its privy orifice. It was a lovely morning, gorgeous beyond imagining, were brassy halls of winter depression fierce daffodils, blaring yellow-white reveille, and crocai gingering the lawns in tessellate performing rites society. No need for wellies, Florrie, shawl about her sparrow shoulders, took the interminable beige thing she was knitting into the hall. Startled, the flowers arose. Gingerly, through tiptoe, grey spheres where shade her substance, whispers walk, and Maya reigns. About Florrie, in stone postures various, were 207 gnomes. Sitting in some home garden, hearing in a singing song, thinking of a summer long ago, when one was 21. Naming all the flowers so friendly, shouting in the shrubs so thick. But lo and behold, the media, one bite and the bishop was sick. Everybody, how nice to be here!